Augmented reality combines the real physical world with the digital world. With it, you can create just about anything you can imagine. Personally, I've created 3D illustrations, new types of jewelry, interactive sculptures with spatial graphs, and even a Valentine's Day card that comes to life with a sweet animated story. Essentially, this is a brand new tool, a way to tell stories, whether they're data stories or more traditional narratives. In short, we're currently witnessing the birth of a new medium. That doesn't happen every day. And just like any fledgling medium, it has to develop to discover what it's really good at, rather than just emulating pre-existing mediums. For example, in the early days of cinema, shots typically copied theater. All of the footage was pulled back and shot straight ahead, as though it was being filmed on a stage with a proscenium. Later, people began experimenting and discovered that film could do things like close-ups and jump cuts, stuff that couldn't be done in a traditional theater setting. We're at a similar crux. We don't know what AR is capable of or how best to use it, and the only way this medium is going to come into its own is if lots and lots of artists, like you, make lots and lots of art with it. In the last few years, the AR software landscape has totally changed. Things that would have required an entire team of developers, you can now do on your own. Adobe Aero is free, drag and drop, and you can create AR experiences without having to write a single line of code. Now, everyone can participate despite their technical expertise. This will prove to be pivotal in the evolution of the medium. So, how can you get started making augmented reality? Well, that's why I'm here. This series of videos will cover the ins and outs of creating AR experiences, including workflows, best practices, visual design techniques, interaction techniques, and even audio in AR.